bridge that we have to cross to get to the coast. We're 460 miles from San Francisco and about halfway through the ridge. We call it a ridge because it's an elongated stretch of the high pressure system that's running the length of the U.S. West Coast. It's about 100 miles wide. It looks like a river that we're crossing. And if we stick with the river part, we're halfway through it. We entered it yesterday afternoon, and today, as the sun is coming up, it's about 4 in the morning. It depends on the time zone you're using. We're halfway through, maybe a little bit more. I'm going to try to zoom in on these jellyfish and see if you can see those. Got little sails moving across the water. I can't wait to read more about them because we've been blessed with seeing these for 4 or 5 days now as they just sail past us. Who knows where they're going or how far they'll go. But they're always with us. It's really interesting. Look how calm this water is. High pressure system takes away the wind, along with it the waves and the sound, so it's quiet. We just have this gentle motion. Sails are down. No point in having them up if there's no wind. And we should see the wind in about 10 hours from now. We'll be on the other side of the lake, the river. The end of the wind is going to carry us to the coast. It's kind of the final part of this trip, or this part of the strategy of the return trip, was sail north to get to this latitude, turn east, sail along the top of the high pressure, which is what we were doing the last 5 days, and then the high changed a little bit and created this ridge that runs up and down the west coast, and so now we have to cross that ridge. The high, even though we talk about it as the high, is never one thing. It's constantly shaping, breaking apart into smaller high pressure systems. And that's part of the chess match of navigation, trying to figure out what those high pressure systems are doing, because they're dictating the winds. As pressure as pressure flows from a high pressure system to a low pressure system, it's like water flowing from a mountain to a valley. All that pressure just flows off, and then when it does, it spins the wind. And coming off of a high pressure system, it spins it clockwise. So around a high, when you look at it on a weather map, wind is turning clockwise, and it spins it counterclockwise around a low pressure system. So those spinning circles of wind are what you're constantly trying to work into your navigation plan so that you've got the best winds for where you want to go. But isn't this beautiful? Sun is almost up. It's a gorgeous sky. It's quiet. I'm going to be quiet and let you listen to the water for a little while. And watch the jellyfish go by. think it's beautiful. Here's a look around for the boat. The boat that I've been on for the last 6,000 miles over the last 8 weeks. Look at all this fuel. We anticipated having to motor quite a bit more through the fuel, so we brought through the highs. So we brought all this extra fuel, and believe it or not, we may not need any of it. That's 40 gallons of fuel. And over there you see a 6-gallon can of water. That's our sort of emergency backup water in case that we run out, but we've got plenty of water, so we won't use that. This has been my vessel. It's carried me across an ocean. There you see lots of the jellyfish that we just went through. I'm so proud of this boat. Everything about this boat has performed spectacularly. She's sailed well, she's kept me safe, she's gotten me where I want to go. I really do love this boat. That bright moon we've had for the last few days. It's been gorgeous.